Junior and you agreed to pay him more.
But what we didn't and couldn't agree. I will get you every last copper, with interest. Give me a week, please.
Horson's no banker. He's an honest man. You pay on time, you get protection. You don't pay.
Help!
What you hollering for, stupid wench? What are you hoping for? A knight in shining armor?
Close enough.
Keep out of this, Greyhead. Not your concern.
Go. Now.
Now listen. You might have two swords, but there's four of us.
Yeah. Four men, collecting tribute from one washerwoman. Don't think I have much to fear.
Best think again.
That's it.
Cover your eyes!
Covered in blood, all of it. So much work for naught.
No need to thank me. It was nothing.
Sorry. Don't get me wrong, I'm grateful, but everything I had, I just lost.
Don't know if you remember. We've met.
I don't... Wait. Wait, I know you. You're that witcher I near clobbered with a vase when... Well...
When you kicked Dandelion out, through the balcony. Actually, he's the reason I'm here. Know where he is?
Probably out whoring. That horse pheasant. That lying scoundrel.
Ouch. What did he do to get your goat?
Same thing as ever. Prize bullshitter came back, saying it was till death do we part this time. And no more than a week passed before I spotted him in Harborside, strolling with some trollop on his arm. 'Twas the last straw. All those questions about the washerwomen at the bathhouse, then this. I beat him black and blue and threw him out on his ear.
Dandelion ask you about other washerwomen? Not terribly subtle even for him.
Maybe he likes some sudsy.
Maybe. But what did he ask about, exactly?
Oh, this and that, really. What's it like at the bathhouse? Have I got any friends there? What are their working hours? I don't know. Maybe he's looking to hire one for his tavern. Maybe I got all in a huff for no reason.
This woman he was with in the harbor. Who was she?
Claimed she was his niece from Kovir. Ha! Horvir, more likely. Corset so tight her eyes were popping out her head. His too, come to think of it. An artist or a whore, doesn't much matter as they're one in the same.
Thanks for your help. Listen, when I find Dandelion, anything I should tell him?
No. I mean, tell him he's a two-faced snake, but it would be nice if he dropped by.
My, aren't you a tower?
fire.
Welcome, welcome. Do come in.
I'm a friend of Dandelion's, looking for Elihal.
You've come to the right spot. How might I be of service? Need something shortened? Patch your trousers, darn your socks.
You, Elihal?
Yes. Now pick your jaw up off the floor.
Sorry, I thought. Thought Elihal was one of Dandelion's girlfriends.
Oh, so it's that. Wait here. Any better?
So you're...
Elihal.
Did you and Dandelion... I mean... How did you two meet?
I met him one night in a tavern. He was blind drunk.
What happened?
What do you think? We spoke.
That's it.
I'm not sure what you're getting at, but I should make one thing clear. Men don't interest me. Told him that as well. Luckily, Dandelion's an open-minded fellow. We had a lovely evening. He became a loyal customer afterwards.
Dandelion visit your shop often?
I tried many times to talk him into a decent doublet. Sadly, he'd only come in to get a button reaffixed or a hole patched.
When did you last see him?
Some time ago. He brought in one of Zoltan's jerkins, insisted I sew on an extra pocket. Odd as requests go, I had the distinct feeling he'd actually come to talk.
What did you and Dandelion talk about? He asked about anything in particular?
Let me think. Had an ordinary chat, really. Although, indeed, he did keep asking about Kalkstein. If Dandelion and I hadn't laid our cards on the table at the start, I might have suspected he had a history with the alchemist. He spoke like a lovesick beau. In fact, he desperately wished to meet with him.
Kalkstein's in Novigrad? Wouldn't mind seeing him myself.
You're too late, I fear. The witch hunters nabbed him recently, burned him at the stake in Hierarch Square. But as he perished, ooh, the goings-on, impressive. Fiery beasts circled his pyre, then rose into the sky and exploded to form letters.
Really? What did they spell?
Radovid sucks flaccid cock.
I know this is none of my business, but why do you...
Why do I dress up? As a child, I dreamt of becoming a Doppler when I grew up. I became a tailor instead. Discovered clothing. Costumes can express all the complexities of one's personality. I'm a Redanian countess one day, a dockside thug the next. That is true freedom.
Mm-hmm.
Have you never thought to become someone else? Even for a moment? Must be horribly boring being a witcher all the time.
I managed to stay interested. Thanks for your help, and nice to meet you.
I can help with much more. If you need new trousers or a vest, you know where to find me.
This Baronet's La Valette's villa.
Shouldn't interest you. The Baroness don't mingle with just anyone.
Don't worry. I'm here to see your chambermaid, Molly.
Out of the way. Baroness is riding out. Be gone.
Geralt of Rivia at my doorstep? Surely this is no chance encounter.
Greetings, Baroness. Greetings, General. You're right. I'm here for a reason.
There's no mistaking you. But for etiquette's sake, Mary Louisa La Valette, an Imperial General and a Witcher meet. And know each other. Surprising.
Yeah, we had an opportunity to, talk when the Emperor summoned me to Vizima.
Had you run afoul of Var Emrys? No. You'd be long dead if that were so. It seems, then, that you share some interests. But I shan't question you out of doors. Will you accept my invitation? Tell me what brings you here.
Looking for a girl named Molly. Heard she works here.
My maidservant. I'm afraid she's currently at the home of my dear friend Patricia Vagelbud.
Perhaps Geralt could accompany us. He could speak with Molly at the races.
Is that something you'd consider, Witcher? Care to partake of some sophisticated diversion?
Well, if Molly'll be there.
On our way, then.
We've arrived.
My father owned a similar estate in Bruges. As a young girl, I'd travel there often to ride.
Shall we look at the horses? Do you like horses, Geralt?
I guess so. Called every horse I've had Roach.
The grey mare is Cantarella, sired by Cahir, the champion from Vol.
Grey's a nice color. For horses, too.
My coin's on the black stallion, Nemrod, purest Nilfgaardian stock.
Surprised he didn't salute you, General. Know anything about the chestnut or the bay?
The chestnut is Thunderbolt, a pure-blood Ritanian, gallant steed, but too headstrong for my taste, difficult to control. And the bay hails from Zericania. Lord de Volta acquired him recently. I know little about him. Though, Zericanians are reputed to have incredible stamina.
Seem to know your horses.
No is not the word. Morvran's a true expert.
I find them to be far more honest than men. Must say, I'm curious how you manage in the saddle, Witcher.
Mostly just try to stay in it.
What would you say to a little race?
Not what I came here for.
Don't make me beg, Witcher. Tell you what. Win, and I shall give you my finest saddle, made in Nilfgaard proper of beautifully tanned leather.
Why not? Wouldn't mind seeing if your knowledge of horses translates into riding skills.
Well said. So, which steed do you choose, Witcher?
Heard tales of Zericanian horses. I'll ride the bay.
I'll not ride with you, but I shall bet on a steed. Nemrod will win, no matter the rider.
Cantarella for me, then. I see no point in delaying this. Let's begin.
Riders ready!
Come on, Witcher! Let's see what you're made of!
Come on!
Don't spare the horse! Come on, Witcher! Let's see what you're made of! Don't spare the horse!
What a thrill! A beautiful victory!
Thanks.
For one for whom every horse is a roach, you carry yourself exquisitely in the saddle. My congratulations.
That is yours.
Now, could I talk to your chambermaid, milady?
Ah, yes, Molly. That is why you came here, after all. The portly young woman. That's her.
Speak to her. And you must find us when you're ready to return to Novigrad. We'd be delighted to join you for the journey.
Nothing hurts as much as life.
I'm Molly, my lord. Wish to see me?
Call me Geralt.
Geralt? That Geralt? The one Dandelion's rescued time and time again?
Mm-hmm. Wouldn't be here if not for Dandelion.
Told me all about your adventures. How he'd ready you for battle with his songs. How he tamed the Cairn by playing his lute.
I meant that literally. Dandelion's why I'm here. Came to ask you about him. Know where he might be?
No. Sadly, I haven't got a clue. We've not seen each other in ages. The Baroness don't approve of our acquaintance. Says Dandelion's a good-for-nothing layabout. Can you imagine? But... or maybe his sister could help you. Such a nice girl.
Any chance you remember your last conversation with Dandelion?
Course. He came to borrow some coin for a barge.
What? Why'd he need a barge?
To take me on a romantic cruise of the canals by the light of the moon. Said there'd be strawberries and that wine with the bubbles, and he'd sing me arias. But I've not seen him since.
You do realize Dandelion doesn't have a sister.
Sure he does. Saw him himself. Funny, she don't look like him at all. Blonde, for starters. Maybe they've different fathers.
Mm-hmm. Different mothers, too.
Maybe. But you could see he cares for her. Looks after her. The way he carried her packages and...
Know where I can find her, Dandelion's sister?
I know. Whenever I asked Dandelion when we'd visit her, he'd grow all quiet and then change the subject.
Thanks, Molly.
Wait! Before you go, I've got a request. Dandelion told me once he'd show me his etchings, but he never did. And I'd so like to see him.
Won't be too hard to convince him. He loves showing off those etchings to anyone he can.
Oh, that's wonderful! Thanks, and good luck to you on your search.
Washed your hair lately?
Ah, Geralt, there you are. Shall we return together?
Gladly. It's a long way to Novigrad. Road ought to seem shorter with some company.
I'd say the same. Well then, let's go. And here we are. Thank you for your company.
Likewise. See ya. Winds howling. Excuse me. I'm looking for Mirabella.
I am she. Wait outside. Class is in session.
I'll wait.
It won't take long. It turns out he'll not come
Mom!
After all.
Where are you?
A rat bit him, and he's caught a fever.
Where'd he get bit?
It hurt him much.
Will he die?
You don't die from rats, stupid.
Yes, you do. Just the other day I saw Witch Hunter tell a man,
catch a
you rat,
by the
and then he killed
if
him.
If he sees you, let you go. Run
That's
away
enough.
And don't be slow.
We're done for the day. Gather your things and go home.
La, 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 la.
Wonder if the rat catcher will get well.
Like as not.
How do you know?
Mum says that if he but catches a cough, he's as good as in the grave. This one's got to be all right.
My daddy's a witch hunter and chases old crones.
Now can we talk?
Yes. What do you want?
I know you saw Dandelion recently.
Oh yes. Longest afternoon of my life.
He read you his poems.
No. We perused the Illustrated Guide to Fungi.
Maybe... No. Won't even try to guess why he wanted to do that.
Mold. That was his interest. When his hand abandoned my knee to point at a figure of penicillium, I knew the fire between us had died. Permanently.
See Dandelion after the fungus incident?
No. I even considered granting him another chance. His heart of hearts is pure gold. He simply needs a bit more discipline in his life. But he never came back to see me. So I thought if it's done, it's done.
Found a poem Dandelion wrote about you. Portrayed you as an unusually talented individual.
Really? Did he mention my poetry? Horses have always fascinated me. I've always longed to extol their noble beauty. Did you see any of my work at Dandelion's? Mere exercises, true, but I'd be curious to know what you thought of them.
No. Didn't see any.
Gee up! A snakely whip rose skyward. Gee-haw! Crack! She reined the beast in. The stallion danced betwixt her thighs. Lather bathed its chinny-chin-chin.
Sorry, don't know much about poetry. Thanks for your help. Farewell.
Jesus creepers! Look at the creepers! Out!
Go on.
Nothing pretty in this life save daffodils.
The impudence! You heard? Some kobolds, some godless dwarves.
Hey, not like that. Enjoy that.
Driving in slippery, the bugger was quick as a top.
Did you see those?
What do you want?
Rosavar Atra's expecting me. Supposed to give her lessons in swordplay.
Come with me. Miss Rosa awaits. You realize what you've got yourself into?
Hope so, too.
Miss Rose has got a downright beastly temper. Shows no mercy once... Grab a wooden one! And take care not to hurt the little miss. You'll earn it. Follow me.
You're my new instructor. Well, well, Papa clearly went out of his way this time. Wood, to start with. I must know your worth. Why bother with two swords when you can barely handle one? Damn it! Well fought. You're much better than the last one.
I'm not actually your swordplay instructor.
Really? Then who are you? And how on earth did you get in?
I'm a witcher. I'm looking for...
A witcher? That's splendid. I always wanted to meet a witcher. This is so exciting.
What's so exciting about it?
Living on the edge. Tracking, then facing down beasts. Sleeping under the stars. Oh, it must be wonderful.
Try fighting a Zoogle while up to your neck in sewage. Nothing quite like it.
Not one of the high points, I suppose. Wait, weren't you about to ask me something?
Before I ask, gotta admit, you do pretty well with a sword. One pointer. Don't expose your left flank when you dodge.
Oh, I know. Terrible habit. Can't seem to get rid of it. I'd hoped to find someone in Novigrad who could help me to do so. But don't you dare try to dazzle me with advice. Already admitted you're not here to give me lessons.
Came to ask about your rhetoric tutor, Dandelion.
Rhetoric tutor? Good one. That is why Papa hired him, but not at all what the bard had in mind. He mostly played his lute and sang for us. I believe he thought he was wooing.
Mean he wasn't? But you had some sort of relationship?
If you call him chasing after me a relationship. Even so, there was nothing between us. Seems my sisters had a bit of fun at our expense. But enough chatter. Stand and fight. I demand a rematch.
You'll never learn.
Stop blowing and fight! Why bother with two swords when you can barely handle one? Drat it! You're quick!
Come on!
Not an instructor, you should certainly be one. Fancy giving me a few private lessons?
Can't rightly refuse a request from a lady.
What are you two lovebirds whispering about? You asked about my relationship with Dandelion? Well, here's the mix-up's mastermind, Edna Var Artra. The greatest mischief-maker north or south of the Yoruga.
Wait a minute. Mean to say Dandelion mixed you two up?
On occasion, yes. But then Rosa would quickly set him straight. If you'd shut your catty mouth for a moment, dear little sister, I could explain. Edna sent Dandelion some love letters. She signed my name. Conceited as he is, naturally he fell for it. I was left to repel the aging bard's advances. Rosa, I had the best of intentions, you know that. I felt you needed help taking the first step. You blushed every time he sang a ballad. He'll next sing at your funeral if you don't stop it right now.
Calm down, ladies. No poet's worth two sisters nipping at each other's throats.
Especially not this one.
Listen, I just want to know one thing. Either of you seen Dandelion lately?
Edna might have. I certainly have not.
My dear sister, I would never spend time alone with a man for whom you burn with a secret passion.
Burn with passion? For one who incessantly praises another woman's talents? Afraid I've more sense than that.
Dandelion act any different lately? Notice anything strange?
Strange? Not really. It's no use, Geralt. She's so enamored, she'd hardly notice if he turned into a werewolf.
Edna!
What? You needn't pretend he followed convention. Remember when he took us to the cemetery?
Rhetoric lessons in a cemetery. Unusual even for Dandelion.
We set out to visit the graves of celebrated Oxenfurt professors. He ended up quizzing us about Margrave Henkel.
Who?
Eccentric old coot. Died recently. He'd apparently been an important and generous patron of the arts as a young man.
Bet sophisticated young ladies like you know a bunch about politics.
We've picked up a few things. What would you like to know?
Emperor continuing to push north. Courtiers must be ecstatic.
His confidants must be. But Papa says that's not likely to last much longer.
Why not?
Papa says the war's disrupting trade, and people are tired of financing the Emperor's adventures.
Wonder how the war's going. Any outcome looming?
Papa says much depends on Radovid, and on who captures Novigrad first.
What's Novigrad got to do with it? Free city. Never taken sides. Always stayed out of conflicts.
Oh, even children know Novigrad's home to the world's largest fleet. And they say the city's treasury's bursting with enough to equip two armies.
Changing subjects. Who'd Dandelion sing about? Know anything about her?
I believe she's a poetess, or Trebaritz. Very skilled and exceptionally talented, of course.
This woman. Not a local, right?
I seem to remember him praising her melodious Kaviri accent.
Makes sense. He referred to her as Kalonetta a few times. Bizarre names are common in Kavir.
Gotta ask Zoltan about this Kalonetta. Been a pleasure, but I've got stuff to take care of.
Exceedingly nice to meet you. Please come again. Well, can I expect any more lessons in future?
Awfully convincing, miss. Wonder where you learned it. Name the time and place.
House here, tomorrow. Same time as today.
See you then.
See you, Master Witcher.
KSN? Hey, Swix.
Another drifter in from Temeria.